I greet my viewers with another liberal message from such outstanding politologists like me, Armen Akhnoujian. Well, actually, I want to address American public, you know, actually, and the international worldwide public as well, with vital issues which might actually affect international public's well-being and actually its major principles and ideals of Helsinki Human Rights Act. I believe that Russian government, including Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin, resorted to cold war against Russian immigrants in the West. This year, at the beginning of this year, corrupt nationalist Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin declared a cold war against Russian immigrants in America. He actually called upon them, you know, to return back to Russia, and he called upon Russian scientists abroad to return back to Russia. Even though he knew that Russian government adopted a human rights violating initiative that prevented Russian citizens from ever leaving their country until they pay their real estate tax, and was that real estate tax wasn't paid by many Russian agents, as Russian government refused to collect real estate taxes during sales of their apartments, houses, or condos, in order to penalize Russian citizens and violate their human rights to free travel. In other words, they tried to make Russia a jail of the people, like it used to be under communist regime, Russian nationalists. And now that Vladimir Putin, Russian Prime Minister, former KGB agent and Russian nationalist from United Russia Party, or former communist functionaries, he actually made an open and quite Cold War style statement in which he, this year, beginning of this year, in which this Kremlinist, along with the Communist Party leader Zyuganov, and Russian ultranationalist Vladimir Zhirinovsky, this Russian odious Russian Prime Minister Vladimir Putin, called upon Russian immigrants to return to back to Russia, because he actually had delusions about Russian scientists working for Bill Gates and stuff like that, and he wanted them back. After having a round table with Zyuganov, Russian communist leader, and Vladimir Zhirinovsky, Russian ultranationalist from Liberal Democratic Party, who actually supported this anti-immigrant initiative of Russian Prime Minister from KGB and former Russian CPSU communist functionaries, United Russia Party. And I believe that most Russian immigrants abroad should know that any attempt to lure them back into Russia will end up in them being unable to ever leave Russia again, because Russian government adopted human rights violating customs policy of not letting Russian immigrant Russian citizens leave Russia until they paid their real estate tax. And most of the Russian immigrants didn't pay real estate tax, as the Russian government refused to collect taxes during sales of sales of their apartments after privatization and Russian Revolution in 1991. And I believe that intellectual public, mostly, which is my audience, actually, was intellectual audiences, we should actually believe that we should penalize the Russian government with sanctions. I believe the United Nations Organization should penalize Russian government with sanctions for violating human rights of Russian travelers, Russian citizens, by refusing to let them out of the country until they pay their real estate tax, which is impossible for them to do, as they already spent all the money, proceeds obtained by selling their real estate. I believe that this particular offensive violation of human rights might affect many Russian immigrants, which I may be unaware of, with human rights violations of Russian customs, the Russian government led by ultranationalist KGB, ex-KGB agent Vladimir Putin, and his former communist Dmitry Medvedev, who actually does not want to veto information and libel law, which prohibits Russian press to criticize Russian people and Russian government. And this information law used to allow Russian Ministry of Information to issue to close down any news edition after three warnings if it was news edition decided to criticize the Russian government. This outrageous violation of human rights to free speech, you know, which is should be as well noted by United Nations Security Council and should be punished by sanctions of United Nations organization for violating human rights. Also, Russian Constitution should be changed, I believe it. And with Article Article 131, that article that prohibits anybody to criticize the Russian people, this article is violates human rights. And actually opening genocidal and reactionary article, a neo-fascist article, which I've seen in the Russian Constitution during some times. This article actually sent many Russian dissidents to jail for so-called anti-Soviet propaganda and agitation. My mom was once charged with anti-Soviet propaganda and agitation by KGB in Russia for criticizing a lack of freedom in the former Soviet Union. And my mother, Ignat Nugent, wrote a letter to her French friend, Emile, in France in the 60s, in which she claimed that there was no freedom of speech in former Soviet Union. And KGB agent illegally read that letter using X-rays, X-ray machine, and they actually fired her from work and illegally sentenced her to 2 weeks of home arrest without any court trial. And I believe that me myself, being an anti-communist, and maybe, but I actually always opposed violation of freedom of speech and freedom of travel in the former Soviet Union. We were considered that communists were actually one, were two cold, not cold war, they won civil war in World War II, by the way, not national. National didn't win World War II. Which I admonish my right-wing opponents in the West. And nationalists did not win Russian civil war or Chinese civil war. Reds won. And most of them were communists or socialist revolutionaries. And actually, American Republican, right-wing American Republican lost to Democrats. Democrats, like President Obama, now stands for liberal socialism. He promised to bring an era of liberal socialism to America, in his own words. Like he used to say that anything he said might come originally from him, but unfortunately liberal policies don't work this way, and he should admit that liberal politics will prevail and will come from most liberal Democrats. I believe in freedom of amnesty, such liberties like amnesties to illegal aliens, eligible illegal aliens, workers, ex-felons to own firearms, and same-sex marriage bill, and living minimum wage of $10 an hour should become agenda, legislative and executive agenda of Democratic President Obama. He wants to stick to liberal agenda. And I believe liberal capitalism actually work. But as a Democrat, I believe only capitalism with a human face, with a social program, that might only work. The only way American capitalism work, because of social programs, like Section 8, with rental subsidies, with pensions. Without those subsidies, rental subsidies, and programs for poor and elderly, in home support for elderly and poor, actually American capitalism would never have worked. Nobody cares for a system for people, working class people can't make money. So thank you for your attention. I hope that liberal reform politics will win in will be adopted by Democratic President Barack Obama, which I consider to be a great leader.